Well, hello, farm and friends. Welcome back to another edition of Farming Simulator 2015 with me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose. Back on the farm here at Manchester with the Soul Mod installed and ready to do a little harvesting today. We've got some canola in field number 4 that needs to be harvested. And we're going to do that today. And, yeah. And then whatever else we get into. I've got to get my tractor moved over here and put into place. We're going to grab a couple of these gravity feed trailers. We could probably do this whole farm today with just one trailer because we're doing canola. And as y'all know, canola doesn't, you know, you don't get as high of a yield and not as much tipping that needs to be done as with wheat or barley, but just to be on the safe side, I will run two tractors. And this one is about out of gas, so we need to bring him over and top him off. While we're doing that, we can grab one of our harvesters and head on out with it. So anyways, we got a little weather forecast. Let me get this. There we go. I always forget to config that before we get started. Alrighty, now we can roll on. As y'all know, we have hail in the forecast for today. So we want to get this field done and harvested before that happens. And then I can sit and do other stuff while that happens, fill up the mix station and things of that nature. So, that's sort of my game plan for today. And then, of course, our other fields will be ready for harvest tomorrow. Or on the next day, who knows when that would be, because I might sit around and play with the mix station or whatever in a video or do something a little bit different. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and start harvesting here, and what I'm going to do is, what I've found works for me for field 4 is to go ahead and cut in and begin my harvest and get this north run done, so that this north edge is already cut before I start heading up the other side. When I do, I tend to, if I don't, a lot of times I end up on that east leg. I end up having to call for my tractor to come offload me, and when I do, because of the way the field is shaped and the trees on the edge, my chase vehicle tends to run into a tree. So by cutting this edge first and then offloading up here right at the corner, I ensure that I don't have that issue. And I don't have to worry about a vehicle running into the trees when trying to offload. Probably not as much an issue again with canola, because we won't have as much of a harvest with the canola, but it never hurts to just go ahead and do this and be preventative just in case. 34%, we wouldn't have filled up, but doesn't hurt to go ahead and get everything taken care of. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and get this guy fired up. Get this guy out of here. get him set up to do his legs. And I'll end up harvesting this the same way I've done before. You guys have probably seen me harvest a million times now. And so what we'll do is we'll set this guy up on auto combine to chase me, and I'll cut the lead cut, and he'll cut the trail cut, and that'll be how we can do this. All right, so we need one more tractor, and this guy will do. I know, I haven't replaced this out yet. I'm going to. Just hadn't done it yet. And, man, I tell you what. Old Serious Gamer, he's something else, man. He is on top of it. He's awesome. I'll say that much. I got a couple of messages from him about that John Deere, because I spoke in the video about how it didn't whine like this one does, you know. And he's like, oh, well, there's a fix to that. Here are two different ways you can fix it, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, wow. It was like, I don't mean it in a derogatory manner towards him or anything. It's my observation about that particular mod. And, but boy, the guy's on top of it. He's awesome. And I appreciate all of his input. Alright, so we'll move this guy around. And we'll set him up. I actually need to run him over here and dump this combine real quick. 26 miles an hour is unrealistic there, Moose. Come on. Oh, so yeah, I'll be adding that tractor in. I should have done it before this, but I just didn't think about it. I'll get it added in though, and we'll talk a little bit about it. I probably ought to do a video just on it, because just to talk about that particular mod. Alright, so let's get set up here. This guy's going to be in combine mode. He is going to be assigned to a particular combine, which would be the one right here next to us. We're going to put him in four-wheel drive mode, and we're going to have him drive the course. Oh, but we got to give it a course, so we're going to give it grain to silo field number 4. Yay! Alright, so that is all set up. And now we can just say drive course, and he will do such a thing. Really, all he's going to do is go down here and sit in the next to a waypoint. Alright, so tab through, grab this guy. We need to do the same thing with him. We need to set him up so he is ready to roll. And we'll just pull him around here. We'll go in and put him into combine mode, assign him a course, which is going to be grain field number 4. So let's hit that. That's good. And we will give him a combine to work with, which will be this one right here. Put him into four-wheel drive, tell him to drive the course, and he is off to the races. And then we need to get this guy set up and running. And what we'll do with him is just cut him in, put him into auto combine, and then we'll set him on his way. So just cut in a little bit, make our turn, get straightened up here, and we're good to go. Bring up auto combine. And again, with auto combine, we've got auto combine on. That's what turns the little feelers on. You can do offsets if you needed to. Distance keeper just keeps them from running into each other. Unload mode while driving means he stays moving when he's unloading. The active side is this side here, is our sensor side. and we're going to be going around and around in circles, and the reverse mode just is how it makes its turn. And that is it. Everything looks good. Hit that. Hire the help. And let's get in the other combine and get some work going. So, pipe in. Make our turn. Catch the corner of the field here. There we go. And we are off to the races. And now we can turn on cruise control. Sit back, grab a newspaper, drink some coffee, and just not really worry a whole lot about anything. Not true, you'd have to change your head elevation and all that. Oh, you know what's funny is, somebody ridiculed me the other day in a video because I didn't show you guys how to elevate the header on this thing. I was like, seriously? It doesn't matter. I mean, if you're going for ultra realism, okay, yes, you can switch over to the header. You can hold down your left trigger and you can actually raise the thresher head and you can actually compact it in and out so that you can change your thresher adjustments. But this is a video game and it has nothing to do with the amount of yield you get or the proper threshing of your harvest. But I found it hilarious that somebody had to take the time and write a post and go, "You didn't tell people about the adjustable head. You do realize that the header is adjustable on the combine. You should point things like that out." Huh? I didn't know there was an international standard for making videos that said, you should go over each and every function of each and every piece of equipment from day one when you get started. Not really. I did it in a video a long time ago. Does that count? I'm sure there's a video back in the My Big Country series that, where I talked about adjusting the combine head. Yes, I go for realism a lot in these videos. Ultra realism? Not so much. I don't walk to every piece of equipment. That would be a little crazy. Alright. Come on, Mr. Deer. Get on down here so we can offload this before we get down to the south leg. I'm going to hold up here a little bit. And I'm just going to creep to this corner because I want to get offloaded and get him dismissed so that he doesn't run into me when I make my turn and he doesn't run into the ditch over there. So there's a reason I'm not driving and offloading at the same time, in case you're wondering. There we go, because I want him to stay right there until I make this turn. And I don't want him to, on his when he makes his little forward pass, I don't want him to drive into the ditch. And I wanted to unload him on that, well, this is a west leg, but on that south leg, I wanted to unload on it because I didn't want him to try to offload me over here and run into this ditch. So that's the reason I offloaded so early. Which technically it wasn't early because I was at about, say, I think it was around 50%, 60%. So it wasn't too early, but it still was earlier than I normally would call him in. And it seems like that other one is just closing in on me. So, alrighty, so we'll run through the field here and continue on. We're doing pretty good this week. It is Thursday, and I've managed to get a video up each and every day for FarmZone. Y'all gotta be pretty happy about that. How did I miss that swath? Moose is on fire. He's back to his old self. Not distracted by fishing. Let's just say I took a fishing vacation, right? And yet the John Deere is slipping and is turned red. What did he run into? And somebody's blocked. Seriously. The AI is so stupid. They all three got down in the corner down there and have run into each other. I guarantee you that's what's going on. I'm telling you, my sister's kids, they are just absolutely stupid. Well, let's see what we got going on over here. Oh, well, this is just ridiculous. I stopped him early. He still manages to run into a ditch. And then the case wants to drive right up this guy's butt. So he can't do anything. You're about stupid, dude. Alright, let me get this guy over here and just set him out of the way. Grab this guy and set him out of the way, because he's stupid. What do you mean? I'm sitting in the wrong spot. Oh. Alright, that one's cleared out. That one's moving. This one, pull it up a little bit, or if I hit drive course, I'll probably run into something. All right, now I should be able to get back to work. The life of a manager. You can't help stupid, can you? Alright, so we'll start our east leg again. And this guy's gonna come unload us. And we're just going to keep on going. So I think we'll go ahead and we'll do another video tomorrow on Manchester, and that will be who knows what. And then for the weekend we'll probably do a little forestry, and who knows, we might attempt another live stream this weekend. I know, I keep teasing y'all with those live streams, right? A little nervous about the whole live stream thing, though, with the way my internet's been. It can just come and go at any time. So, I don't know how that's going to work out. But, we might attempt it. So, at this point, it's pretty much a given now that every day at 11 o'clock, it's going to go out between 11 and 11:30. And when it goes out between 11 and 11:30, it just kind of comes and goes, comes and goes, comes and goes. And it does that for about 30, 45 minutes. And then it all of a sudden miraculously stabilizes and it runs for a while. And then around 4 o'clock, and these are central times, it does the same thing all over again. And then it stabilizes and works for a bit. And then occasionally, for no rhyme or reason, it just goes completely out and stays out for 2 hours. I love these tram lines. They are so awesome. I'm so glad they added that into Drive Control. Again, I don't like them on the seating part of it, but for the rest of the game, man, that's just too cool. It adds something so much to the game. So anyways, but yeah, we'll get back into doing a little forestry because I sort of miss them. I keep looking over at my joysticks sitting on the shelf thinking, oh, you guys are being neglected. Maybe I can talk Mr. Recon into doing a video Friday night. If he's got that kind of time. And we can do some forestry together. Because I think forestry, again, is much, much better when it's multiplayer. Might even be able to find a guy named Landy Kid this week and get him to do an appearance in a video since he is making his triumphant return to the Isle of Britain after his summer vacation in Canada, which I know that was having to leave yesterday probably was a sad time for him to have to leave. But he should be back to making videos this week since he'll be back at his home base. Maybe we can get him to do a little multiplayer. That would be cool. That'd be cool to get the three of us back together doing some multiplayer. Really cool, and this would be a stretch. We'd be getting Mr. Raven back in and get four people. Man, that would be amazing. I've been doing a lot of third person in this game, hadn't I? But looking forward to the rest of this week. I think probably I'll do an LSPDFR again later on today. Probably do another LSPDFR. And then probably bust out a little Euro Truck. Do a Euro Truck video today or tomorrow. Get that done. Then I'm probably going to be pretty busy for the rest of the weekend. So it'll be just a farm sim video probably for the rest of the weekend because it is a busy tourist weekend. So last big push of the week or the season or whatever. After this weekend, it is full steam ahead for kids in school, and I mean, we're already so slow it's not even funny, but we'll have this weekend will be our last big hoorah, and then it's just the work is so sporadic. When it was when we were a small company and it was just the two of us, we stayed busy because, well, it was just the two of us and we made do. But with it being a larger company now and there being a lot more people to manage, I just basically took my hat out of the ring and said, you know, don't worry about me. I'd rather just not even have to worry about it. I'm making mine anyways. You know? So yeah, this is probably the last weekend that I have to even work. And then I am done for tourist season. And we'll have all kinds of time to focus on video games. Not! I'll have a lot more time, but I've got some other things I gotta focus on. Corn harvest is coming up. And then it's planting greens. So all that's gotta get taken care of. Aside from other things I gotta do around the house. Leaves are already starting to fall. Deputy B and I have been talking about this. It has been unusually cool already. I mean, it's August coming into September, I know that, but it's still pretty cool outside. Woke up this morning, it was 61 already. And you probably think 61, that's not that cool. For here, that is pretty cool. I mean, looking at the weather forecast, we're going back into the 90s, so this little trend is going to be short-lived. But to wake up in the morning and it's 61 degrees, that's quite a shocker. What is he doing? You idiot. I'm looking at my left edge and that moron just comes plowing across the front of me. So yeah, it seems a little early for it to be changing, but it is already starting to change a little bit. Normally the low is down in the 70s. High 60s, low 70s. This is dun dun dun. I gotta wait on them to do something. Come on. Back up. So I started in the lead and now I'm trailing. And this guy's gonna be an idiot. What is he doing? What are both of them doing? Don't know what's going on here. You gonna work or what? All right, so we'll make this draw in. Make him make his turn. our turn. Getting down to the bottom of this. I think what I can do is, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let him make an east run, and I'm going to flip around and go south. Because I don't have enough in here for the offloader to come in, so it won't matter. So I can come in here and cut, swing around, and I can cut south. And in the time it takes me to cut south and turn back around and come north, I'm missing a lot over here. I have to come clean that back up. Oh, and he's blocked over there because of the John Deere, so I'll end up just finishing this field off myself because he's too stupid to drive. Alright, well, that's gonna about do it for this harvest. Oops, missing a little bit again. Boy, I'm getting sloppy. Alright, let's go ahead and let's stop him from working. Lose that. Right. Stop the driver. Over here real quick and finish this up. And we'll be done. So I did a little mod skinning yesterday for the first time. Never done anything like that. But Deputy P's gotten into customizing vehicles for GTA to make different police mods, but wasn't really sure how to skin them. And since I had a background in doing graphics design, I helped him out with it, and it was kind of fun. Sort of piqued my interest in it. So who knows? Maybe I can do some farm sim stuff later on down the road if I learn a little bit more about it. Did I even offload anything in him? I didn't. He just sat there and followed me because I didn't even have my boom open. Alright, so we are clear. Everything looks good. This field is done, so we can wrap up, move all our vehicles back to where they need to go, and then we can go check the status of our other fields. I think, if I remember right, they're way too wet over there. That we're going to have to do a little something with them. I think we're just going to let them set today. I think that was the game plan. Maybe put a little PK on our soybeans. Alright, so let's get on under here. Let that dump. But yeah, I sort of enjoyed that little bit of just skinning a vehicle. I look forward to messing around with it. I downloaded a bunch of software and some trial versions, and I'm going to mess around with that a little bit today, maybe. See if I can figure it out. Who knows? Maybe if I spend enough time doing it, I can, like I said, make some farm sim mods. So instead of just complaining about there's no quality mods for this and no quality mods for that, who knows? Maybe I can actually learn a little something and down the road be able to do something. Who knows? Probably not. Probably lose interest in it really quick. And it's probably way above my abilities and skills. I'm good with code, and I'm good with just basic graphics design, but when it comes to 3D modeling, and not so much. All right, let's run through all these guys, pack them up, and get them put back where they belong. Get the wheels unfolded on that big boy. And pack up the... Nope, I didn't... That's not what I said to do. Come on now. There we go. Pack up that. Switch back over to this. And we will pull this over here back behind the shed and park it. We need to remember on the next, after we harvest the soybeans in on our next day, after I harvest them, I need to go in there and plant some grass and drop another shed down, because I want to get these stored differently in a different place, as well as I want to have more storage for vehicles, period. That's the only downfall to this map. It just does not have enough storage on it, because we're going to be buying a truck and trailer soon and need to have a place to store that. But right now we don't. And then I got my corn header sitting back here in the back of the shed behind the combines, and so need to find some other ways to store things. Alright, so we beat the weather. Though I don't see any weather. It's probably not going to come in till like 11 or 12 o'clock, probably. Both of those are dropped. Park this guy. So funny, I started playing LSPDFR again yesterday after not playing it for about 2 weeks. Don't remember where any of the controls are. it was like learning all over again. But that game is fun. So we'll roll back around here, drop this guy off. here. I'm going to sit here and say, oh, I'm getting a lot better at these gravity wagons or backing up these dollies. And now watch, by saying that, I will hose myself. Yep, pretty much hosed it. Alright, if I do this and then correct back, really? Yep, not gonna happen. Yeah, I'm getting really good at them. Can't get that front axle to turn enough. Stupid thing. They either turn way too much or not enough. Eh, I can deal with that. It's in there. Definitely something I gotta work on is my skills backing up these dollies. And I don't know what it is. In real life, I can back one up in a heartbeat. But I've said it before, I think a lot of it just has to do with physics in the game is part of it too. I just think there's not enough weight on that front axle to make it respond properly. And I think that the weight on the back axle tends to let the front axle plow too much. Let's see, what am I thinking about doing here? Thinking about going to a vehicle that's running, but for some reason, it put me in the shed with something I haven't even touched today. Never will understand why it does that. Alright, I think I'm going to take this guy real quick and run over here. And let's look real fast at our PDA. And let's look at our livestock. Chicken. Cows. Alright, so we have productivity. I'm looking for mixed rations. I need a lot of mixed rations. So I'm going to go ahead while I got this trailer on. Pull under here and fill up. Why aren't we filling up? I know there's mixed rations. Come on now. Oh, turn that on. 100,000 mixed rations. What, this trailer doesn't hold mixed rations? Really? Are you kidding me? Really? Oh, I gotta look. I gotta get my curiosity now. Seriously. Gravity wagons. Nope. They only hold the basics. Seriously. That is so wrong. Alright, well. That puts another strike against them. I mean, I was using them. I was starting to like them a little bit. And I was thinking, oh, these are pretty neat. But I can't hold anything but the four basics in there. Well, that ain't cool. Might be selling them off. Well, we're definitely going to have to invest in some other trailer because I cannot be hauling feed from the mixer to the I can't be hauling feed from the mix station to the over to the cattle in that little 5,000 liter trailer and expect to make any headway, especially seeing as every day they're going to use probably 20% of my feed up. So we'll have to probably lose one of these guys or both of these guys and then go a different route because that ain't going to work. Boy, I'm just having all kinds of trouble with these. Forget it. I'm not even going to mess with it right now. I'll come back and... Actually, I'm going to just do it the easy way real quick. Well, that even turned bad. Yeah, I'll get it later. I'll get it later when I have time to actually deal with it and not lose my freaking mind over it. So, yeah. Guess we'll go over here and get a trailer and just keep putting... Where did I put that trailer at? Oh, is it around front here? Yep, there it is. I love this trailer, but it's just too small for what I'm going to need to be doing. With the amount of, you know, with the amount of goods that I'm going to have to be hauling in to that dairy barn now, given that we have a 1,000 head or 100 head of cattle in there and going to be increasing that up every time. 1,500 is not going to do it. I mean, that's like 8 loads to get enough into here. Increasing the number of cattle sounds like such a great idea until you realize I'm going to have to feed them basically every day and going to constantly be putting straw in here. But is what it is. Those gravity trailers, man, they're still killing me. I knew I jinxed myself the moment I said something to the effect of, hey, I'm getting a lot better at doing this. Yeah, I'm getting a lot better at this. Watch this. Now I can't even back them up. How are we doing on the rest of this stuff for our cattle? Let's see. Mixed rations. Yeah, if you remember yesterday, we had like 30% in there, and we're already down to 19. And I just put a full trailer load in there, so we are going to have to be on the good foot with this. Which means I need to take the time to get all the silage taken care of, and we're gonna have to plant a ton of corn. Yeah, I need to get that mix station maxed out and get it running, and make sure that it stays at 100%. And even more than that, I need to actually get some done and set off to the side. So but we need to get all that silage out of the bunker and get that bunker cleared out so we can start making some more. And this would go a lot faster if those gravity wagons would have held mixed rations. Such a good idea gone so wrong. Straw is already down to 7%, so I'm gonna have to go do some straw, which means a lot of loader work. I really got to, at the end of this video, I've got to go cruise some mods and find a better straw bucket for that particular unit. Either that, or I just need to go get a loader. I probably need to buy a loader if we're gonna do this much. We're going to have a lot of manure to shovel. We're going to have a lot of feed to work at this point. I probably need to just go ahead and buy a loader. And the loader heads, I think, actually do the straw. So that's probably what we'll end up doing, is just buy a loader. Which one to get? Do we get a traditional wheel loader, or do we just get a telehandler and use the telehandler? So many choices to make. What's our water level look like? Water level's good. They've only used 10,000 liters of water. Right. You know, it seems like it's starting to haze up a little bit. Maybe that weather is getting ready to move in. It didn't seem this hazy earlier. Alright, so we're starting to get all the troughs filled up, which is good. We got 50% mixed rations in here so far. Alrighty. I can live with that for now. Definitely need to get another trailer. So probably pick up a loader. I don't really want to get a conveyor belt, because the conveyor belt takes away the, you know, using the loader, which I think, you know, for speed, you can't beat the conveyor belt, but you know, there's something about doing the loader work. So might just probably just buy a loader and use a loader. And I'll look. I'll either get a telehandler. I'll either get the Merlo or grab a front loader. Probably grab the JCB. I'm not a fan of the New Holland. I don't know why. Alright, one more pass in here, and then call this a video. But I hope you guys enjoy it today, and we got a little harvesting done. We are on our way to another harvest tomorrow, which will be soybean and corn. So we'll get those done. Might do a little bit of loader, like I said, I might do a little bit of work off screen, just getting that mix station filled up. So I don't know, I have mixed emotions about getting a loader now, and I will say this, I like using that case as a multifunctional tractor because it does have that ability to put a loader on it, and even the 1050s have loader abilities that you can put loaders on them, so I like that, and I'm a little bit don't want to get rid of them, but at the same time, that straw head only holds 700 liters at a time, and that's just absolutely ridiculous. So I gotta find a better solution for it. So anyways, we will probably in the next video swap out the John Deere's and put the 8370 in, so we'll probably drop that in. We'll probably pick up another trailer that we can use for, you know, doing livestock work, and I will look for a different bucket to use instead of this grapple, because I can't stand that grapple. It just doesn't scoop enough. I really wish the bucket held a little bit more than it does. It just seems a little low capacity and a little small for that tractor, but then the only other thing I have that mammoth one that is just too big. So, all right, guys. We'll wrap this video up for today. It does, like I said, it looks like it's getting much, much hazier. And probably weather will be moving in here soon. Because it is starting to cloud over. The sun was out a little while ago, and now it's starting to get very, very cloudy on us. So I expect the hail to start following soon. Anyways, I'll probably do a little bit of yard work here, and then we will get to the harvest tomorrow's video, and we'll get these fields cleaned up, and then I've got to make some decisions about what direction we head with this farm. I think we probably need to pick up another field. Definitely want to, like I said, I want to put some grass on this, basically here, and then we'll plop down another tool equipment shed right over in here somewhere, and that way we'll have some more storage to be able to put some equipment in and get it out from underneath the weather and help us out. But these guys look good. I probably need to put some dry PK on this field. The end values look pretty decent. They'll end up around 4, but the PK is going to be too low for me. I need to go ahead and bring it up. I need to look at what the penalties are. I think for every one, you lose 25%. So definitely don't want to hurt ourselves that way. So let's just go ahead. Probably it'll be worth running some wide tram lines through there to get that increase. So, all right, we'll venture into that tomorrow. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like the video, make sure you give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do. I do a new video each and every day. That's about it. Thanks for watching, guys. And as always, to that one guy that dislikes every video I do, thanks for watching. Appreciate you sticking in there with me long enough to decide you hate the video. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Until then, stay safe. Have a great day. Bye-bye.